Hi everyone, this is Luke with Carlson Cash. Today we're going to run through the Reconcile Cash Flows app in S4. Reconcile Cash Flows is an app that we use to make sure that as we receive current day information, we're now not double counting both our forecasted items with our current day bank statement activity. This app is a relatively new app to the cash management solution, so we thought it would make sense to cover this app in detail and run through a few of the key features. In our previous videos, we've run through the intraday bank statement monitor to make sure all of our statements have loaded. We've also taken a look at our cash position and the cash flow analyzer. We're now moving on to reconcile cash flows. So let's assume we've had another current day bank statement that's been loaded. And before we view our cash position, we want to make sure that we do a quick reconciliation to make sure that everything that we've already forecasted now hasn't shown up in our current day bank statement. And if it has, we now go through the process to reconcile those two items together. Okay, so getting into the system here, we have our Reconcile Cash Flows app right up here. So we'll drill into that. And as you can see here, we have a lot of the same selection screens we've seen on a lot of our Fiori apps where we can decide what we want to view in this app. So we'll just take a look at our main accounts here in 9100 and we'll reconcile those. I think it's important to note that there are two ways that you can reconcile with this app. The first is upon upload of the current day bank statements. There's an auto reconciliation that takes place when the bank statements are loaded that finds those matches automatically for you so you don't have to go through this process. You can also manually match items together that didn't auto reconcile, which is the process we're gonna walk through right now. So as you can see here, we have all of our accounts that are gonna require reconciliation. And so we've got our company code, our bank country, our bank key, everything related to that account to tell us what account this is. And it's also gonna tell us when we brought in our last current day bank statement. So as you can see, we had our last bank statement uploaded today, and it gives us a time and when that bank statement was uploaded. So we're gonna drill into this account and see what reconciliations need to be done for this account. Okay, so now we have a little more detail, a little more information about this account. It's also letting us know that it's got a reconciliation status of open cash flows and mem records. So we know that we've got some reconciliation to do here. And the way that this screen is broken up, we've got all of our intraday mem records or current day mem records sitting up here at the top with their mem record number. Towards the bottom, we have all of our forecasted items. So these are all our forecasted cash flows that we have sitting in SAP that have been manually created in SAP. And then towards the bottom, we have all our reconciled items. So these are the items that we either manually matched and manually reconciled, or were automatically reconciled when we imported the current day bank statement. So we can drill into these and see what these items contain. But we're really more concerned about what items didn't reconcile. So it's very easy here. We can take a look at our intraday memo records or our current day memo records, and also our forecasted cash flows, and do any exception processing to match those two items together. So as you can see here, we've got an $80,000 memo record created from the bank statement. We also have a forecast for that for $80,000. So it's as simple as choosing the two items, clicking the reconcile with intraday button here. And what that's gonna do is that's gonna reconcile those two items together, let you know that they've been reconciled successfully, and they'll now appear here in this lower tray of reconciled items. So as you can see, it is a very manual process, but this is something it really should be more of an exception type processing where most of the items or a majority of those items should automatically reconcile when you bring your bank statement in. But there is an opportunity to manually reconcile those items together. So as you can see, this is a really great tool to use to make sure that the information you're looking at in your cash position is accurate and everything's been reconciled. You're not double counting your forecast with your actual bank statement activity. If you have any further questions, feel free to reach out. Thank you.